Steve Dotto here. How the heck are you doing this fine day? Me, I am in somewhat of a sharing mood today. We're all in a sharing mood these days, are we not? I think it's the evolution of social networking that has caused us to be far more engaged in the act of sharing everything in our lives. We share on Twitter, we share on LinkedIn, we share in YouTube, we share in Pinterest, and we overshare on Facebook. But what is it we're sharing? We're sharing content. Some of us are sharing valuable content, and others are sharing content which is maybe not so valuable. I want to create a linkage today, a linkage between where we find valuable content and how we go about sharing that content in our social spaces. So today we're going to look at social sharing from Evernote on Dotto Tech. Each of us uses Evernote in a slightly different way, but one thing that's common about all of us that use Evernote is we use it as a sort of a digital bank account. We use it to store all of the little pieces of data that float around in our digital lives. And just like a real bank account, the stuff that we've deposited, all of the information that we've deposited in that bank account is only valuable when we get a chance to spend it. It's basically digital currency. Now, what do I mean by spending it? Well, using the information that we collect to further our purposes, to finish off a project, to do some writing, or perhaps, as is in the theme of this particular video, to share with somebody else. Let me show you how my day kind of progresses. I use Evernote on a daily basis as I'm doing research, as I'm reading through and deciding what sort of videos I'm going to be creating for the channel. And when I find something that's valuable, something that's interesting, that's something I might want to do a video on in the future, I save that to Evernote using the Evernote Web Clipper. Now, I've shown you the Evernote Web Clipper in the past. It is a phenomenal tool for doing research and gathering information. But it also facilitates us sharing information as well. So let me show you how it all works. So let's say I'm going to do a story on Apple's fancy pants new watch. Oh, it's so exciting. Apple's got a new watch. I might want to do a story on it at some point in the near future. So this is a good article. It describes a lot of things that I'm interested in. I want to save it. So I click on the Evernote Web Clipper, which launches a little pop-out that allows me to save either the article, a simplified version of the article, which is what I like to do because it strips out all of the advertising and ancillary information. I can save the full page. I can save it in a variety of different styles. This isn't what's important right now. What's important is the fact that I can save it, and then when I do save it, it's going to sync it to Evernote. But another piece of magic happens at that time. Let me click on save and you'll see what happens. Is that up comes this little dialog box telling me that it's syncing it with my Evernote account. This syncing with my Evernote account is what's so important, because what's happened is it's taken this article, the one that we just saved, and it's made a copy of it in my Evernote account, which lives in the cloud. That means that it's basically taken this document that I found and converted it into a web page of my own, one that's living in my Evernote account. And the fact that Evernote lives in the cloud and everything is basically has a URL or a web address means that we can actually use this information and start sharing it. And here is the first evidence. As soon as it's finished syncing, and let me just pop over quickly into Evernote so you can see that this, if I sync my account right now, you see that the note is living here in Evernote. There it is in Evernote. We'll come back to this in a second. But before we do, look at what I've got here at the very top of this dialog box that basically confirms that it's synced. It gives me the opportunity to take this note right now and share it to LinkedIn, Facebook, Twitter, Google+, insert it in an email, or just copy the share URL. See, the URL, this share URL is what's so important. If I just click on that, what it does is it will create this little link. And now this, what it does is it takes the note, it converts it into a sharing format. Does that make sense? It converts it into a format that can share, because if you think about most of your notes on Evernote, they're private. You don't want to share them with others. But by choosing this process and copying it to the clipboard, creating a shared link, it turns the note into a shared Evernote note, which means that I can then send people this URL and they can, in their browser, view my Evernote note. Now, I use this technique to deliver courses and for a variety of other things, but it works great for social sharing because this URL you can put anywhere. You can put it into Twitter. You can shorten it up. If we're going to use the the dialog box here and we're going to actually say share it on Twitter, we can then compress it. We can use a bit.ly link or we can shorten down the URL so that people can view it. But it allows us to basically share any document or any bit of information that we clip with the Evernote web clipper. It allows us to immediately share it to one of our social channels without opening that social network at all. Of course, we've had to sync this. We've had to create a connection between our Evernote account and these other social platforms. But now we can effortlessly share current relevant information into our different social channels. Isn't that cool? This is a great way to basically leverage the value of all of the information that you're clipping. But it goes beyond that. This same philosophy of having a shared link works within the Evernote note itself. So let's go over now, and we're looking here in my Evernote account at the actual note that I saved and just synced through to my system. And if we take a look here, we've got within the note the ability to share it. Now, they don't give us quite as many social networks to share from once you're in Evernote, but I can share it immediately to LinkedIn, Facebook, and Twitter. So the big three are available to me to share with right now. And of course, I can copy the public link as well here, which creates that same public link that we saw just a few moments ago, and I can share that by email or any other form. So if we think about the flow of information, we find good relevant information online. Now we want to store it because it's a currency that we might want to use at some point in the future. If we want to share it right away using the Evernote web clipper, we can very conveniently immediately share it with our social network. If we want to store it, digest it for a little while, maybe think about it and share it at some point in the future, Evernote again allows us to share from directly within the application without ever having to launch Facebook or Twitter or any of the other social apps on our computer. That's it. Sharing in Evernote. I told you I was going to share something interesting with you today. I hope you found our video today to be useful. Remember that there's three ways to stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. The first is please subscribe to this channel. Second is subscribe to our newsletter. That way you'll hear about all of our great upcoming live webinars. We do about one a month and they are awesome. Trust me, you're going to want to take one in. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community funded channel. We're supported by our viewers through the crowdfunding site Patreon. If you would be so kind as to take a look at our Patreon page, you can learn what the perks are of actually supporting Dotto Tech. And the perks are pretty darn good. That's it. All the time I have for today. Till next time, I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming a castle.